How can you tell you're watching a Makoto Shinkai film? He has a lot of personal quirks that separate him from his peers. Gorgeous, meticulously animated food. Infatuations with weather. Love. And the melancholic. His use of music purposely arouses the highest amount of emotion. But above all else, it's his visuals. Your Name has an abrupt difference in its visual language due to the film's two distinct settings. Tokyo feels grand in scale. Filled with blinking lights and skyscrapers, Shinkai highlights the dense population, the chaos of a bustling world full of life, and the beauty of a restless culture. Itomori, on the other hand, has nature shown in almost every frame. Its rurality is presented with vibrant greens and warm reds. There's a deep history ingrained in the stones that make up its foundation. The film ties these two settings together through red thread, a visual motif. Red thread is also what ties together the film's two protagonists, Taki and Mitsuha, a physical representation of their fate as lovers. The contradistinctive settings are there to show how distant and different these characters are, and it's only when those two worlds collide that some of those wilder visual sequences get to flourish. But that's an exception to the highly detailed style that Shinkai made a name for himself with. That style isn't without its own substance, though. His films wouldn't be anywhere nearly as impactful if they took place on just some generic backdrop. For Shinkai as a storyteller, his backgrounds are more than just the space that the characters inhabit on screen. Those backgrounds can set up tone, mood, and atmosphere. But most importantly, the backgrounds are a window into the setting and can be a great visual representation of the character's emotions. In 5 cm per second, the film both opens and ends with the coming of spring and the fall of cherry blossoms. And this has more meaning than just being good wallpaper material. Akari and Takaki are just like the two falling petals of a cherry blossom tree. They started out together, but slowly drifted apart. While in the Garden of Words. Shinkai uses the weather as a motif for the love between the two protagonists. The hut where Takao and Yukari meet is painted as a sanctuary to escape from the world. The sound of the city is muffled by the rain. It's a place where the two can share their solitude with one another. When the rainy season is over, they separate and grow distant from each other. And when reunited, it pours. Though, however dissimilar they are in their approach to love and weather, they're still uniquely Shinkai. Shinkai's voice can be found in visual motifs that are present throughout his filmography. Trains. Sky. signs and brands. When devoid of most of those signature quirks and motifs, Shinkai also loses his voice. His 2011 film, The Children Who Chase Lost Voices, is more of a Ghibli film than a Shinkai one. The fantastical setting is rendered stunningly, but Shinkai's visual language finds itself strongest in modern settings. It's also where most of those claims that he's the next Miyazaki fall flat. His female leads often find themselves being rescued by the male leads, unlike a majority of Miyazaki's, and his films repeatedly find themselves lacking in key scenes that fully develop their characters. Perhaps even more fundamentally, Miyazaki's speciality is turning the fantastical into the everyday, where Shinkai turns the everyday into the fantastical. There's a lot of effort that goes into making a Shinkai film look photorealistic, the core of his visual style. Take a look at this random shot from his 2019 film, Weathering With You. Shinkai adds a depth of field so both the foreground and background are out of focus to emulate real-life cameras. There's also the light reflection on the surface of the puddle and on each individual splashing droplet, as well as an asphalt refraction from beneath the surface of the puddle and the glow of the shop light bouncing off the wet pavement. One of the ways you can identify a Shinkai film is the way light interacts with the environment. His pursuit of realism isn't just some hollow attempt at live action. Shinkai delights in the everyday things that we often ignore. The way light bounces off a faucet, or how snow sticks to the windows of a train. Water beating up on a small branch. Vending machine drinks while on a bench. All those details contribute to the emotional poignancy and melancholy he explores in his films. From She and Her Cat and his origins on a Power Mac to his most recent, like Suzume, Shinkai is a director who evolves with each project he undertakes. And no matter how big or how small, from a feature-length film like The Place Promised in Our Early Days to a one-minute short like A Gathering of Cats, they all contribute to his growth as a filmmaker. Each one is a stepping stone to his making of a film without his shortcomings. And the connective tissue between these stones is his visuals. He's not just emulating real life. He's highlighting what makes us feel alive.